In this tutorial series, we revisit an oldie but a goodie, the Snapshot Tool. The Snapshot Tool clones an animated object over time. The help file shows an example of using the Snapshot Tool to duplicate ice cream cones. While this is a valid scenario, the Snapshot Tool would be better used as a motion analysis tool rather than simply a modeling tool. This multi-part tutorial is divided into three different themes or scenarios. The idea for the first scenario came to me while watching an episode of the series Dogfights on the History Channel. In Dogfights, they often show a tech animation to display the trajectories of fighter planes following specific paths. In this particular case, one plane uses a maneuver called a vector roll to get behind its enemy. The animation certainly shows how the planes are positioned and oriented at any given time as the animation plays back. I then thought about using the Snapshot Tool to duplicate the position and rotation of fighter planes to show the maneuver differently. This way, you get both the animation and the static positions and orientations of the fighter planes over time. Using this technique, and even without the animation playing back, you can still make out the acrobatic maneuver. While I was developing this idea, a second one came to mind, and that is to animate the visibility of the duplicates to create a ghosting effect. Just to make it more interesting, you'll learn about that effect using a different animated scene that involves a car crash. Instead of a path that the car travels on, you'll use a dynamic simulation to animate the car's motion. Finally, I thought of a third theme in which to use the Snapshot Tool. You'll learn a way to use Snapshot to build a wave based on an object's motion. Consider this animated bat that you may have already seen in a different tutorial on this channel. It has a very simple motion, traveling up and down once or twice while flapping its wings. You'll use the Snapshot Tool, along with another trick or two, to convert those flapping wings into this wavy piece of geometry. You can then keep it as a static image for a tech company logo, perhaps, or animate it in its own right to create some cool effects. As you can see, a lot can be done with Snapshot and a little bit of ingenuity. So if you're ready, move on to the next movie in the series and start animating the fighter planes.